This, I mean, just let's just keep this in perspective. There is a criminal investigation going on of one of the president's top associates, his former national security advisor, one of the most handful of most important people in the government. He gets fired. He's under criminal investigation, and the president brings in the FBI director and says, please stop your investigation. Right. If that is an obstruction of justice, I don't know what is.
I'm sorry, you go ahead.
Oh, what's striking to me about this is
that's significant. That, I'm still sitting on that.
You know, from an FBI agent's perspective, we record these kinds of conversations all the time. They're very dry. There's not any editorializing or about, you know, how it landed on you and what your interpretation of it was. So mm-hmm. what's striking to me, and I'll be interested to know whether this is also reflected in the memos, is him actually giving his interpretation of the meaning of what the president was saying, mm-hmm. which may on its face could be kind of excused away. But as Jeff will probably attest to, obstruction of justice is a very complicated crime because the proving the intent is the key. And so for him to say, I understood this to be essentially a direction to stop the investigation, I think is a pretty striking comment.
But I think this demonstrates that the obstruction statute is also pretty simple. We know what is not in is going to be even that much higher.
And he's also a private citizen. As a former FBI special agent, I think it's just we're in the weeds on this and everyone's reading. Yeah. But just take a step back.
Yeah.
How big do you think this is?
Well, listen, as the director of the FBI, I don't think that he would have normally been in a position to come back and document conversations with other senior executive branch officials and put them in a file. That's what rank and file investigative case agents do. So, again, I think that this just, you know, attests to how much of a concern this is. I suspect that senior leadership team included the general counsel of the FBI, who advised him to document this. And, you know, I think that his statements are going to carry a lot of weight because the things that he's quoting in here are probably taken verbatim from those memos. And those are contemporaneous mm-hmm. records, which...
I think also listening to you, it's, you know, we're reading it and there's been so much reporting on the memos and the memorialization of these different meetings. But to sit there tomorrow, Mark Preston, and mm-hmm. for, you know, the world to listen to this first person perspective, to hear the words.
Basically the trying to shut down the investigation of Mike Flynn, because that is not just asking for a statement. That's asking for FBI to take action. Mm-hmm. And that, I think, is much more serious since the president is the boss of the executive branch, which includes the FBI.
I know you wanted to jump in.
Yeah, two things I don't want to get lost in what you've been reading is, number one, Comey's repeated attempts to go to the Department of Justice and get some assistance from them, whether it's guidance or, you know, insulation in helping him, and not getting it. So the first time Sessions tells him, I can't promise you that I'll never leave you alone with the president. I mean, you know, the fact that he even had to make that request tells you a lot. And then in the passage that you just wrote, that he went again to the acting deputy attorney general and said, I would await your guidance, and didn't get any.
Right.
You make a very good point here, because one of the Republican talking points since this story has come out
it?
Is like,
why
well, if this was so terrible,
right. why didn't you go
to Sessions? Why didn't
you? He did.
And he did. Several times.
And the other point I just want to quickly point out is the emphasis that he did not tell the agents working on the case, because he's acting preemptively there in terms of not allowing the credibility of the rest of the investigation that's been going on to become accused of having political bias, which, you know, I think we can see coming. He's nipped that in the bud by saying only a small number of people at the senior level of the FBI knew about this. The agents who've been investigating this all along have not been aware of this.
I do think that as we're sitting here at this table, we have to look at this through the eyes of what we think America
wrong legally at the beginning. And that was the whole point of this. The other thing that I'm getting, just texts from Trump loyalists, come on, you know this is all political. And you know what? There are people who have legal hats like yours or have maybe more kind of how government works, common sense hats on, who are going to say, no, it's not political. But you can be sure that they're going to say, this is a man scorned. This is a man who was fired by the president, and he's got an axe to grind. Mm-hmm. I am not saying that that's, you know, correct, but I'm just giving you a preview of what I'm getting, mm-hmm. of what the Trump sort of defense
and this is why the memos matter.
Because
he wrote the memos before he was fired.
Exactly.
He wrote them. I'm reading in the very beginning of this, January 6th. He said, I began to type it on a laptop in an FBI vehicle outside Trump Tower the moment I walked out of the meeting.
Wow.
And the other thing I'll point out is in this first conversation, which you haven't read yet, Brooke, and I'll save it if you want to, is that he does assure him on this January 6th meeting, he assures the president that there was no counterintelligence investigation.
Counterintelligence.
That is an important distinction.
Yes. Why?
Right.
Because counterintelligence investigations are fundamentally different in purpose and scope and methodology than a criminal investigation. In a counterintelligence investigation, you're looking at foreign intelligence activity in the United States. Have people been targeted? Are they vulnerable? Do foreign adversaries now have access to sensitive information or secrets, for example? That is very different than, you know, a criminal investigation is a separate entity. It's a separate right. division of the FBI. It's a separate division in the Department of Justice. And he makes it clear at the January 6th meeting that it was not a counter, that there was no counterintelligence.
So why does that matter?
It does matter because
it's one of the three.
The president interpreted that as I'm free and clear. A counterintelligence investigation is narrow, is very, very narrow. Comey's